Welcome to the Two Guys in a Cooler channel. If this is the first time you're tuning in, we'd like to say welcome. My name is Eric, and today we've got a spicy episode for you. We're going to be making fermented black garlic chocolate chili sauce, the hottest sauce of its kind on the planet. And I did not have to go very far. In our backyard, we're growing some of the world's hottest peppers, chocolate variety, from the Reaper to the Moruga to the Naga. We got the Ghost. We've got the Trinidad Butch Tea. And so we got a lot of different peppers. And let me show you how we're going to do it. We're going to start off by using some Rio Grande black garlic. This is hands down my favorite black garlic to use. And this is what the chocolate peppers look like after they've matured a little bit and taken on a whole lot of heat. Now, these particular peppers are not your average peppers. They have a very smoky, a very fruity flavor, and their heat index is through the roof. And we thought that the smoky fruitiness would pair perfectly with that umami, chocolatey, you know, black garlic. So we've got our peppers, we're gonna have some sea salt, and then I DIY'd a little fermentation container. And all I did was I poked a hole in the top of the lid, just big enough so that I could put an airlock. And the first thing we wanna do is we wanna sanitize everything. I use a sanitizer called Iodophore, because it's super simple. Technically, all you have to do is spray it in there, but I wanted to give it a good dousing. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put that Iodophore in there, I'm gonna pour it out, wait 2 minutes, and then it's good to go. It's harmless, odorless, edible. You can do all kinds of crazy things with it. Here we go, it's time to use these peppers. Now, you can ferment chilies with whatever pepper you want. And if you're gonna be doing super hot chilies, you definitely wanna have either a face mask and some gloves, or at least some gloves, right? I'm gonna create what they call a pepper mash. So that's gonna have my black garlic, my peppers, and basically I'm gonna weigh it. Because what I'm looking for is I'm looking for a 2.5% salinity content. And what that's gonna do is that's gonna create an environment that's inhospitable to unwanted bacteria. So right now it looks like I need 5 grams or 5.4 grams of sea salt right in there, and that's what I got. Now, normally you don't have to do anything else. This will create its own brine. If your peppers are thin-walled like mine, then you may want to add a brine. And what I'm doing is I'm adding some freshly made sauerkraut juice, and that's also going to contain a lot of lactobacillus, a lot of that bacteria that we're looking for to jumpstart the process. But if you just put water at 1 teaspoon per cup, you have the perfect brine, and you can let your peppers ferment in there. They may just take a little bit longer. As I close it all down, I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit of water in that airlock. And what we're gonna try to do is we're gonna try to create an anaerobic environment in which there's no oxygen. And as long as I can keep a no oxygen environment, then unwanted bacteria is not gonna wanna grow. And so now we let it rest. This process can go anywhere from 2 weeks to 2 or 3 years, even 5 years on up. The longer you let this ferment, the more flavor and complexity you're gonna develop. Notice my airlock's going crazy just after 1 day, and then you're gonna start to see bubbles form, and that's the bacteria really getting nuts. After about 14 days, which is kind of the minimum, but technically you could stop it whenever you want, you're gonna have a pepper mash that is lacto-fermented. Now, when you open up your container, you should smell peppers. It shouldn't have any off smell. If it does have an off smell, that means something went wrong, and you may want to toss it, because a lacto-fermented product is generally meant to preserve. That's how they used to do it back in the day. They would ferment things so that they would be a little more shelf stable. This is the brine from my mash. I separated it. I've got some salt, some vinegar, some honey, and then this beautiful secret ingredient. That's called xanthan gum. And the only reason I'm using that is to stabilize the hot sauce, really to kind of bring it all together and create a lovely texture, and so it doesn't separate later. And in this food processor, I'm just adding each one of the ingredients. Now, it's a trip because you have to taste it all along the way, and this sauce is mind-bogglingly hot, so that became an issue. If you choose to add xanthan gum, add 1/8 teaspoon per cup of liquid that you have, and do it when your blender is on high, otherwise it'll clump up on you. And look at that, what a nice consistent product. It's not going to separate. We're going to go ahead and bottle it up, give it a taste test, and if you got any questions or comments, let me know what you think. That's how you make fermented black garlic chocolate chili sauce. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy. All right, I think it's time to give this hot pepper sauce a taste test. What do you think?
Yes.
Okay, this is the spiciest black garlic chocolate chili sauce on the planet. All right, so let's just get a little bit of that. All right, this right here, that's for you. All right, hang on a minute. Bottoms up?
The whole thing?
Yeah, the whole thing. See what happens. Mm. Go for it. Mm.
Oh. It has great flavor.
I like that.
The heat starts to build like on the back end. It's a great flavor though.
That's a really smoky, man, that's coming in hard. Like that really starts to sneak up on you.
I feel tingly, like all over.
Woo. It's like a really, it's a neat body, like a body experience. Yeah, like the
endorphins just like tingling.
Wow, that's hot.
Mm, it's pretty spicy.
That's good.
It is good though.
There's a sweetness to it, a smokiness. There's a really nice umami flavor. And it's spicy.
It's next level though.
Yeah, I don't know if you...
It's not for everybody, I don't think.
I don't know if you would need that much.
No, you wouldn't. We probably way overdid
like
it.
Like a drop or two would probably be sufficient. Wow. The back of my neck is blowing out with sweat. Mm. Was that crazy?
It is raising the temperature.
It does.
A little bit.
What would you call this sauce? Oh. Just a warning
sign.
Just a sign.
Dab will do you. Like,
yeah,
honestly.
A little dab will do you. There you go. That is a black garlic, Carolina Reaper, Moruga, Trinidad Scorpion, Butch Tea, chocolate peppers all combined into a, I don't know if I could do this, fermented chili sauce. Wow, okay.
Now the stomach is burning. we did a little too much.
I think we did a little.
Yeah.
I'm going to throw up. Wow.